Welcome to this video tutorial on using the library Search Everything research tool. Search Everything will help you find books and ebooks, articles from journals, magazines, and newspapers, book chapters, and a variety of other types of documents. My name is Diane, and I'm going to show you how to effectively use the Search Everything tool. First, please get yourself to the library's homepage at www.library.ryerson.ca. On the library's homepage, you'll see the Search Everything tool at the top of the page, just under the banner. What is Search Everything? It's a search engine that will search the library's catalog as well as multiple databases at once. For the purpose of this tutorial, I'm going to assume you know what a database is. If not, please check the library's help page for a definition. Search Everything's major advantage is that you can enter your search terms in one place rather than repeating the search in many different databases. Unfortunately, it's not perfect. It's trying to search through a variety of different information systems, so its major disadvantage is that it does not always retrieve all of the relevant information the library has to offer. However, it's continuously being improved, and for more simple, straightforward searches, you might find everything you need within the first 2 to 3 pages of search results. Let's use this student's research question as our example. She's doing research in the area of education. Her question is, how do depictions of gender in contemporary textbooks affect students? First, we'll have to identify the key concepts of this question. In this case, they would be gender and textbooks. Using only the main themes or key concepts of your research question as search terms guarantees that you'll retrieve the largest number of relevant results. It's always best to avoid using too many keywords or being too specific, especially at the start of your search. So now let's enter those key concepts as search terms in the Search Everything box. You don't need to put the word and, it will search for both terms by default. Here's what the search results page looks like. If you need to find scholarly or peer-reviewed information, the first thing you want to do is click this box on the left side that says limit to articles from scholarly publications, including peer review. You can also limit by content type. That means you're limiting by the original format of the information. You can limit it to books or a newspaper article, etc. For this search, it's not necessary to further limit the type of document beyond the scholarly limitation we've already chosen. When you see a document in the results list that's interesting to you, you can find out more about it by clicking on the magnifying glass icon. This will usually bring up the abstract or summary, which will tell you what the article is about. At that point, if you decide you're interested in it, you could save it to a virtual folder by clicking on the folder icon, and it will go into your saved items folder at the bottom of the page. Like it says in the pop-up window, this is a temporary folder. If you're inactive on the search results page for more than, say, 5 minutes, you will lose the saved items you put in the folder. The search results, however, will remain intact until you navigate away from this web page. Finally, let's talk about how to get to the full text of one of these articles. At the bottom of each individual listing, it tells you what type of document it is, in this case, a journal article, and next to it, a link to the full text. Clicking this takes you to another page of one or many links. Clicking on any one of those will take you to the full text. I chose the one that's hosted by Scholars Portal because it's first on the list, and I happen to like the way it displays full text articles. Here's the Scholars Portal page for the article, but you'll have to click one more time before getting to the actual full text document. If you have the choice between viewing a PDF or an HTML version of the full text, I always recommend choosing PDF. It tends to display and print better than HTML, but the HTML will also work. When you're viewing the PDF, you'll have the option to save it. Depending on how your particular computer is set up, you'll either get this pop-up window when you hover towards the bottom of the PDF page, which allows you to save it.
Or you'll be able to go to your top of the page menu and
do a file, save as PDF or HTML.
Now, let's go back to the results page, and if you want to, you can fine-tune your search here. I want to keep the refinements we already have, such as the limit to scholarly information only. So before I alter the search, I do want to click on this Keep Search Refinements box. Once you start typing in the search box, you may get this pop-up to suggest some items for you, just like in Google. We're going to ignore it in this case because we're going to search for something specific. Let's say you only wanted to see articles related to depictions of gender in textbooks for high school students. Now, in Canada, in academic texts, that's called secondary school. Always good to include synonyms. Now, the reason I put quotation marks around high school and secondary school is so that the search engine looks for that two-word term, searching for the phrase high school rather than the word high in one place and school in another place. Also, you may have noticed that I put or in capital letters. That's to tell the search engine that this is a command about finding one term or the other. It's not part of my search. Finally, when you put in words or phrases that are synonyms, and when there's only one search box, you'll have to put all the or choices in round brackets or parentheses so that the search engine knows where the choices begin and end. Now we click on search with our newly added search terms. You'll notice that because we've eliminated any documents that do not contain high school or secondary school, the total results has gone from 45,000 something to 10,000 something. Okay, so there's two last little things I want to mention about the limiters in the search everything.
I wouldn't bother with the subject terms that come up because they're not applied in a uniform way, in the way that they would be if you were searching in one single database. If you choose some of these, you definitely risk cutting out some relevant results. However, the publication date limit is very useful. Let's say you only want documents published in the last 6 years and you don't want anything older. You just move the slider up to the earliest date you're interested in, but don't forget to click the Update button so that it's reflected in the results. I've shown you how to refine your search and limit your results. I'm going to show you one last thing, and that's what you can do with the Saved Items folder we sent some records to earlier. You get to those saved items by clicking on the folder at the bottom of the page. Then up pops your list of saved records. You can choose to send yourself these references in a citation format. If you don't know what citations are, please see the library's help page for a definition. You choose the citation style on the left side here, and it will reformat them instantly. You can choose to print these saved records, but the most popular option is to email it. Then you just type in your email address, an optional message if you wish, and hit send. A confirmation message will pop up very briefly, so look for it at the top of this window. And there it is. Then you simply close the Saved Items window. Now I've shown you everything you need to know to perform effective searches with Search Everything. Do keep in mind that you still have the option to search in specific databases. If you find Search Everything overwhelming or you're just not finding what you're looking for, you'll have a little more control on your search. For video tutorials on searching specific databases, please see the library's video tutorials page. Thanks for your interest in fine-tuning your research skills and for your attention to this video tutorial. I wish you all the best in your research. Goodbye now.